International Journal of Health Policy and Management. Quality and speed are our culture and the keys to our success. Welcome to the audio summary section of the International Journal of Health Policy and Management.
Hi, in this video clip we're going to present to you a study called Political Ideology in Stigmatizing Attitudes Towards Depression. My name is Jesper Löve and I'm an Associate Professor in Public Health Science.
And my name is Lena Wängnerud and I'm a Professor in Political Science at the University of Gothenburg. So Jesper, please can you say a few words about the background for this study?
The background is that depression is highly prevalent all around the globe, and we also know that mental disorder, as with depression, are highly stigmatized. And this stigma can lead to discrimination in different ways. It could be structural discrimination, interpersonal discrimination, but it could also lead to people themselves having depression being delaying help seeking since they think this is a bad thing. And we know that from previous studies in the US, there are indications of an association between political ideology and stigmatizing attitudes towards depression. Could you say something about this?
Yes, what I have found in previous studies in the United States is that political conservatism is associated with stigmatizing attitudes. And the thing is that people to the right of the ideological left-right or liberal-conservative spectrum tend to have more stigmatizing attitudes than people to the left. And the explanation brought forward in previous research is that they talk about a certain kind of personality, what they call right-wing authoritarianism. And this type of personality, they need routine in everyday life and they want to have things that are predictable. And therefore, when people with mental disorders or depression come in, they disturb this kind of routine, everyday life things. So therefore, this is the base for stigmatizing attitudes.
The results showed that there were actually an association, even in the Swedish context, between political ideology and stigmatizing attitudes towards depression, both in relation to political ideology index that we'll explain later on, and also what party you voted for in the latest election. But we also saw that the drivers behind this association was different between different conservative parties. Could you say something more about that?
Yes, if we compare Sweden to the United States, in Sweden we have a multi-party system, and this makes it possible for us to distinguish between different types of conservative voters or people. And we have a traditional conservative party called the Moderate Party, and they emphasize more issues of taxation, law and order, etc. But we also have a more recent populist right-wing party called the Sweden Democrats, and they tend to emphasize issues such as immigration. And what we can see in our data is that voters voting for the traditional conservative party, for them the base for stigmatizing attitudes had more to do with personal agency and responsibility. But for the Sweden Democrats, they were more like the results from the United States. For them, the base for stigmatizing attitudes had more to do with predictability and fear, like previous studies from the United States have shown.
The data from this study was based on a web-based survey that has been used in numerous high-quality studies before. We had participants around 3,000 individuals, and for measuring stigma, we used an instrument called Depression Stigma Scale that includes 9 statements. And they could be like, people with depression are dangerous, or I would not like to hire a person that has been depressed, or if I were depressed, I wouldn't like to tell anyone. To conclude, in this study, we saw that even in a Swedish context, we had an association between political ideology and stigmatizing attitudes towards depression. We also saw that there were potentially different drivers between this association, between different conservative parties.